bubbling around the audience here. They're all getting a wee bit giggly. Yeah, our next guest is more used to packed out arenas than small theatres full of thespians. Here telling us about his latest change in direction and explaining that facial hair, it's Keith Duffy.
This is all new, isn't it?
Hello.
Well, hello.
How's it going?
Very good.
When did you get
the
sofa? This is all new.
You may just get our legs out.
I know.
Oh, hang on a second. Nobody told me because I only came dressed from the top. I put my trainers on. I had a lovely pair of brown brogues to go on my belt. I said, "Ah, you'll never see them behind the desk." And now. Well, my ma's going to kill me now when I go home. She dressed me this morning.
Keith, it's a bank holiday. Everyone goes down to Sofa Workshop on a bank holiday, for God's sake. I mean, that's what Now, listen, the last time we saw you, you were doing the high diving board.
Yeah.
Now you're treading the boards. What's scarier?
Treading the boards.
Yeah?
Without a doubt, yeah. I mean, the high diving stuff was terrifying, but... When you're going out there, especially coming from the background that I do come from, and this is something that really I'm passionate about. So when you go out there, you want other people to believe that you're the character that you're trying to portray. And it's more difficult coming from my background. So it scares the...
So this is a production called the whatever.
Didn't even need to finish my sentence.
It's called A Handful of Stars.
Yes, indeed.
And it's set in Ireland in the 1980s, sort of in a pool hall of unemployment. And does it explain the facial hair, or have you just done that?
Well,
for
us? Yeah. The director kind of asked me to grow a handlebar moustache, and I thought, really? I thought he was messing. I thought he were winding me up, and I said, I'll go with it until the last day, and then he'd probably say, I'm only joking. Go and have a shave. He didn't, obviously.
It's quite a small venue, isn't it?
Yeah.
And actually, so you sort of see the whites of people's eyes. It's scarier, isn't it, than an arena?
It's terrifying. Yeah. I mean, I love the job, I have to say. I do love the job. And there's only 63 or 64 seats in the venue. So it's very intimate, you know. But it's a lovely theatre. It sounds tiny, but it's a lovely night out. It's a great night for the audience as well, because they really feel part of the show. But stepping out for the first time, I have to say now, it was terrifying. Because you just see 60, you know. It's grand here because I'm being myself.
Yeah.
You know, so it doesn't matter. Look at me all you like, ladies. It's fine. But when you're looking out there and you're being somebody else, it's terrifying because you don't want to fall out of character, you know. And if I did fall down and if I did get something wrong, I mean, I'd be the first person that they'd slaughter, you know.
You've had amazing reviews. No one's slaughtering you.
Yeah,
so
I know.
Incredible.
The reviews have been amazing.
Well done.
Absolutely delighted.
Thank you very much. Tell us a little bit about the play, because we don't really know much about the play.
Okay, well, it's very reflective of Ireland today, because back in the 80s, there was a recession at the time as well, and there was a lot of unemployment and stuff like that. So if you did manage, if there was a factory in your local town, that's where most of the men would work, and women too. And it was like that in Wexford back in the 80s. And it was basically the 3 days or 4 days of the life of two characters. One guy being a little bit of a James Dean retrobate, not wanting to follow the same as everybody else in the town, wanting to be a little bit different. No, I'm too old for that character, unfortunately. That probably would have been me 20 years ago. But that's Jimmy Brady, that's the lead. And then it's his sidekick, Tony, and they hang out at the snooker hall, and he gets himself into all sorts of trouble. He comes from a broken background, alcoholism, you know, is involved, and then his girlfriend gives him the kick, and that's kind of like the straw that breaks the camel back, and he goes nuts. And gets himself in all sorts of trouble. And my character's an ex-boxer that decides to go back into the ring for one more fight. And that's interesting.
It's a real world away from where you've come from, because you've played arenas as a member of Boyzone.
Yeah.
What's the addiction now? Why do you keep wanting to put yourself through this?
I love being with the boys, because we've been together forever. We've a great time when we're on the road together. And you know, we're actually going off. We're doing a gig in Dubai on the 22nd of May. So it's like I'm getting the night off the theatre to fly to Dubai to do a concert with Boyzone, and then get back and do the last couple of nights in the theatre. So it's good to do the both. But I have to say, as an individual, I get a great reward from theatre. It's what makes the hair stand up in the back of your neck.
And also getting a great review as an individual, because all your life you've been part of a group, which is great, but it's about the group, isn't it, rather than about the individual.
Absolutely. And it's nice at last, at 40 years of age, to get a little bit of individual kind of press and praise, you know?
Well, Keith, sorry to bring you back to it, though. I heard a rumour, and you can dispel it if you like. Is there any truth in the rumour that Boyzone and Westlife are going to
when
come...
When did you hear that?
I did, that you're going to
she
come
just
together.
Made that up. This, is, see, this is what they do on TV.
I didn't
they make something up like that just to throw a spanner in the works when everything was going fine.
Look at me, look at me. Is it true? Is it true?
No.
Busted,
it's grand.
Not Fly have done it.
No, my Fly have done it and they've done it very busted. Successfully. Yeah, MacBusted. It's busted, yeah. Phenomenal
have you actually
success.
Heard that rumour, though? Because I haven't heard that rumour.
Yeah.
You made that up.
I did not.
I tell you, she was out on the drink with Louis Walsh and the two of them decided to come up with a rumour. That's what happened. No, listen.
You'll come back and apologise to me if that happens, I tell you. You will.
That's a great idea. Well done. Yeah, that was thanks. Mine.
Yeah. Call it One Life. It's a
One
good
Life,
idea.
Yeah. Rest on.
So
don't
going
know.
On to what we were talking about just
good
before,
for you. Bring
good
it back there. Yeah, let's go
you're
back
going
there.
On about being 40, which, by the way, is no age, is it?
No. No.
Would you have a blood transfusion from somebody younger?
And now, you see, I kind of want to grow old gracefully, you know. If I was going to do that, I would have done it in my 20s, not my 40s.
And what about kicking them out, the kids?
No, they can stay home forever, as far as I'm concerned. Their bedrooms won't be disturbed, you know. They can go and come as they please, when they're old enough, of course.
And, so it's just misery on the end.
Yeah, there. All right, it's all misery guts on the end.
No, I love a full house and, you know, I love when the kids are there and all their mates are over and stuff like that. I love that, you know. It's great crack.
Listen, sadly, we're running out of time, but just very quickly, hopefully I've not got this. This isn't a rumour wrong. Is it true that you're bringing, Boyzone's bringing out a Motown album for Christmas?
Hopefully, yeah. We're heading over got to Detroit right. in June to record it. So, so we're very excited about that. You know, our new record deal with Warner Music, the whole relationship is going very, very well, and everything is going in the right direction. Unbelievably good. So, 20-odd years later. But, yeah, we're delighted with that. It's good fun.
We look forward to seeing that.
And I'm down in Theatre 503 in Battersea, if anybody would like to come down.
Until the end of May.
Now, it's not panto, it's theatre, OK? Not any shout or screaming.
Is going to be here talking motherhood, model fallouts, music and the Met Ball. We'll see you then, 12:30.